Hello friends, welcome to our channel Aha Jindagi Tricky Maths. In this lecture we will discuss some important concepts about simple interest and then we will solve some problems based on our discussion. Okay, so let's start. Some important terms in this topic are principal. So what is principal? See, when you borrow some amount from someone, okay? So that borrowed amount is called principal. Even if you lend it to someone, then that amount will also be called as principal. So the money borrowed or lent out for a certain period is called principal or the sum. Next term is interest. So what is interest? See, if you borrow some money from some other person, then why he is lending you? Because he wants some profit from that. So the extra money paid for using others' money is called interest. Next term is amount. So what is amount? See, the amount is total money paid by the borrower to the lender. So which is equal to sum of principal and interest. So when you add principal and interest, it will be equal to amount. So now there are two types of interest. First is simple interest and second is compound interest. So in this lecture, we will concentrate only on simple interest. So what is simple interest? See, if the interest on a sum borrowed is reckoned uniformly, that is, principal amount is not changing. Means whatever interest is accruing, you have to pay the interest and the principal amount remains same every year. Even if you are borrowing for 2 years or 3 years, principal amount will be remain same till you pay all the amount. Okay. So let principal is equal to P, rate is equal to R percent per annum. If rate is given half yearly, then you have to convert it into per annum to apply this formula. And time equal to T years. Okay. So simple interest will be equal to principal, that is P, into rate, that is R, into T, means time, divided by 100. And if you know the simple interest, rate and time, then you can calculate principal using this formula, P equal to 100 into simple interest divided by rate into time. Similarly, if you know simple interest, principal and time, then you can calculate rate using this formula, that is 100 into simple interest divided by principal into time. Or if you know simple interest, principal and rate, then you can calculate time using this formula, that is 100 into simple interest divided by principal into rate. Okay. Now based on our discussion, we will solve some problems. So see this problem. What is given? A sum is lent at some interest rate 13.5% per annum. So annual interest rate is given. An amount is 2502.50, that is principal plus simple interest. Okay, so this is the amount and time is given as 4 years. So we have to find the sum, that is principal. So how we can solve this? So we will assume let sum be rupees x, then what will be the simple interest? We can apply the formula. Simple interest is P into R, that is 13.5, into T or time, time is 4 years, divided by 100. So after simplification, you will get rupees 27x divided by 50. So this is your simple interest. Now what will be amount? Therefore amount will be sum of principal and simple interest. So amount is equal to rupees, what is principal? X. plus simple interest 27x by 50. Taking LCM, we will get rupees 77x by 50. Now, amount is given as 2502.50. So, we have to equate both. Therefore, 77x by 50 equal to 2502.50. And from this, after solving, we will get x equal to 2502.50 into 50 divided by 77. And this will be equal to 1625. Therefore, required sum, it is equal to x equal to rupees 1625. Okay, so this is our answer. In the next problem, a sum of rupees 800. Okay, so principal is given as 800 and amount is 920 in 3 years at simple interest. So interest rate is not given. Now, if the interest rate is increased by 3%, increased by 3% means from the above case, from this case, whatever interest rate is there, for the second case, we have to increase by 3%, then we have to find the new amount. So what we have to do, first we have to find interest rate for the first case, and from that we will get interest rate for the second case, then we can calculate the new amount. So principal is 800, so simple interest for the first case will be rupees, that is the amount is 920 minus 800, so it is equal to rupees 120. And principal is given as rupees 800, time is 3 years, okay? Time is 3 years. So we can find the rate of interest. Therefore, rate of interest R equal to 100 into simple interest divided by principal into time, okay? 100 into simple interest is 120 divided by principal is 800 and time is 3 years. Okay, so this we will get in terms of percentage. So after calculating, we will get 5%. Okay, now new rate. What is the new rate? In that we have to add 3% in the previous rate. So 5 plus 3%, that is 8%, and principal will remain same, time will remain same. So new simple interest will be principal is 800 into rate 8% into time 3 years divided by 100, P into R into T by 100. So we will get this as rupees 192. So what will be the new amount? Therefore, new amount, it will be equal to principal plus new interest. Principal is 800 plus 190. So we will get as rupees 990. Okay. Next problem is, a certain sum of money becomes 3 times of itself in 20 years. So a certain sum of principal is becoming 3 times, means amount is 3 times of principal. Okay, in 20 years at simple interest. So interest rate is not given. And we have to find number of years in which it will become double. Okay. So from the first case, we have to find the rate of interest and then we have to calculate the time for the second case using rate from the first case. So how we can solve this? So we will assume let प्रिंसिपल बी पी, अमाउंट इज गिवन है इन 20 ईयर्स अमाउंट विल बी 3 times ऑफ प्रिंसिपल, सो अमाउंट इज 3p. सो वॉट विल बी द सिंपल इंटरेस्ट, द सिंपल इंटरेस्ट विल बी अमाउंट माइनस प्रिंसिपल, सो 3p माइनस p, सो इट विल बिकम ट्वाइस ऑफ p. ओके, टाइम इज गिवन एज 20 ईयर्स, 20 ईयर्स. नाउ वी कैन कैलकुलेट द रेट. Therefore, rate of interest will be equal to 100 into simple interest, that is twice of p, divided by principal into time. Time is 20 years. So from this we will get 10%. Okay, this is in percentage. So rate of interest is 10%. Now principal is equal to p. For the second case, principal equal to p, amount is 2p. We have to calculate the time to double itself. So amount is equal to 2p. So what is simple interest? Amount minus principal. So 2p minus p, that is p. And the rate we have calculated as 10%. Now we have to find the time. Therefore, time is equal to 100 into simple interest, that is p, divided by principal, that is p, into rate. Okay, so this much years. So we will get 10 years as the answer. This is our answer. Okay friends, so in this lecture we have discussed some important concepts about simple interest and we have solved some problems. Okay, thank you.